Yeah, hi everyone. Today we have a pretty exciting topic, generative adversarial networks. Even if you have maybe not had any background in deep learning before you took this class, I'm pretty sure you probably heard about generative adversarial networks. They are a very popular model in deep learning, and they are essentially used for generating new data. Nowadays, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of different generative adversarial networks around there, but yeah, we have to start somewhere. So we are starting with the introduction, discussing the original GAN, and then also implementing a deep convolutional GAN. GANs, like I said, are a pretty exciting topic, but I find they are also notoriously hard to train. So we will also look at some tips and tricks for training GANs. And with that, let's get started. Yeah, so in this lecture, we are mainly going to focus on the traditional generative adversarial networks approach, which was published back in 2014 by Goodfellow and alumni. And yeah, it became really popular around 2016, I would say, when there was a famous NeurIPS workshop where the generative adversarial networks were discussed and presented extensively. So since then, there have been literally hundreds, if not thousands, of different generative adversarial networks. So there was actually a GitHub repository listing different types of generative adversarial networks. And back then, like 3 years ago, there were approximately 150 different types of generative adversarial networks. And it was not updated since then, unfortunately, but I bet there are nowadays probably up to 1,000 different generative adversarial networks. But we have to start somewhere, and today we are going to focus on the original GAN, the original generative adversarial networks model. And also, I will show you a flavor of that later, which is called DCGAN. So DCGAN stands for Deep Convolutional GAN. So the original GAN, the original generative adversarial networks here, was implemented with fully connected layers. And approximately a year later or so, there was an implementation with convolutional layers. So it was called DCGAN. Nowadays, when you hear the word GAN, it usually implies that there are convolutions to be used. So when people say GAN, usually most of the time people actually mean a type of DCGAN. All right, so but to give you some ideas of what we can do with GANs before I give you the lecture overview. So here's like a fun overview of different applications of GAN. Like these are more like joke or fun applications. So there are these different websites. For example, this cat does not exist, and every time you refresh the website, you will see a new cat. And this cat is generated by adversarial networks, generative adversarial networks, and they don't exist in real life. These are generated cats. There's of course also one for face images. This person does not exist. There's also a fun one, this pony does not exist. And then there's also a recent one, this startup does not exist. So these are all fun applications of GANs. But of course, there are many, many different things you can do with GANs. In this lecture, we will focus on the fundamentals, and we will see an example for handwritten digits and also face images. I must say, personally though, working with GANs can be both fun, but also very, very, very frustrating. Personally, I think GANs are among the trickiest things in deep learning to train, because you will see there are now two neural networks that we have to train, and we have to make sure they really are well tuned with respect to each other. So before we had to tune only one network, now we have to tune two networks, and they have to be tuned in context to each other. So it's actually really hard, personally, I think, to train a GAN model. But I will also show you some tips for that. So the lecture overview for today is as follows. I will first give you the big picture behind GANs. Then we will talk a little bit about the objective, so the loss function, like it was presented in the original paper. And then we will talk about a little modification that makes it a little bit more practical. So when we are training it, regarding the gradients. And then I will show you an example how we can train a neural network or a fully connected GAN for handwritten digits. And then I will go over some tips and tricks for making GANs work, because GANs are really, really tricky. And even with these tricks and tips, it's still hard to train GANs. And then I will show you a DC GAN for generating face images, which I spent a lot of hours on because, yeah, like I said, GANs can be fun, but also tricky. So these are our topics for today, starting in the next video with the main idea.